Well, just in the early days, well, I mean, like 3-4 years ago, I mean, he used to just come and see our shows at the Forum in LA. And I guess he liked us. And so I got to meet him, and he kept coming to see us. And then we started talking. And well, when I'm talking to him, I think, my God, he's 25, I'm 37. Yet he's been in the business almost longer than I have, because he started that young. And for me, it's sort of quite frightening when I'm talking to somebody who's 25 you think somebody who was 22 or 25 has just been starting out or whatever, and I could sort of teach him a few tricks, but not Michael.
In the early days, he used to sort of like Queen and used to come and see all our concerts, and so we became friends, and he said, why don't we do something together? This was during, just before the Thriller days, actually. And so I said, okay, why don't we try something together? So it was just me and him. And I went over to his house and did about 3 or 4 demos, you know, to see how they would work out.
About 3 tracks, that was about a year ago, and they haven't been finished. And since then, Michael Jackson's gone, wow. And he's worked very hard, and I've had things to do. So we haven't sort of, we haven't seen each other for about 3-4 months. And whenever we have time, we'll call each other and get that scene sorted out.
State of shock, which in the end I couldn't complete. I couldn't finish, so Mick Jagger did it, right?
Really?
Yeah, well, that's true. So I mean, I actually did the vocals. But the thing is, this is the thing, timing is everything, you know. And at the time when he wanted me to finish it, I just said I can't, because I was working with Queen. I said, I really haven't got time. I was in Munich, he was in Los Angeles, and he said, look, is it okay if Mick does it? I said, fine. So Mick did my vocals. And so I think all that remains is a track that we actually wrote together. And it's a track called Victory, which then he used the title as the Jacksons album, so it was before that. So I mean, in a funny way, I guess that track is frozen, because that's the only track that we actually wrote together, as it were, and so we've got a demo, which sounds great.
Yes, Victory was one of the songs, but he wanted to use the title for the Jackson thing, but the song is still there, and it's probably just waiting until the two of us get together and finish it.
You haven't finished it yet?
No, and I mean, it's just because he has commitments, I have commitments, and it's very difficult. I mean, he's on tour, I'm going on tour, and you've got to sort of, you know, it's very, very difficult when two different, you know, musicians trying to get together. I mean, he has to do his stuff, and it's just that when I was spending some time in LA and we're friends, he said, oh, why don't we try something? So, I mean, one day it'll probably be finished, and well, the other song is called State of Shock, which I did, and Mick Jagger's on it, but it's all okay, because songs are songs. I mean, as long as our friendship carries on, we can write all kinds of songs.
And I could possibly be on this solo album you're talking about?
It could be, actually. I'd like it to be. I'd like one of the songs to be.
There Must Be More to Life Than This was a song that I'd written a long time ago, and it was going to be on one of the Queen albums, and for some odd reason it just wasn't used, because I'd written something else. But I did it in a very different way. I mean, it was the way he sang it is just so beautiful. I just said I have to put a different approach to it. So I put there was more orchestration and the way that I wanted to do it anyway.
On it, I was initially going to be on Thriller. Can you imagine? I blew it.
I think one of the tracks would have been on the Thriller album if I'd finished it, but I missed out.
What attracts two totally separate people, I would have thought, into working together? Because you seem almost poles apart as individuals, not knowing Jackson himself.
Well, I guess you're right. I mean, so maybe that is the attraction. But I mean,
in those days, I think he would actually go out. He'd go out and have dinner. I mean, I remember going to dinner with him. And I think now he just stays at home and doesn't like coming out at all. That's what, you know, that's what he says. I mean, he just he says, or whatever he wants, he can get at home. Because I mean, anything he wants, he just buys it.
But have you have you talked to him about, I mean, just in terms of being an artist or in terms of a song?
Well, I mean,
to stay in the house like that, that kind of isolation, that's so scary.
I know, that's not me, that's not me, but I mean, you know, oh, that's his bag.
Hmm.
And I wouldn't do that. I mean, I'd be bored to death. I mean, I have to go out every night. I mean, I hate staying in one room for too long anyway. I just like to keep moving. It's just an individual approach, you know.